15 years at the helm of Perrysburg football. What does leaving it mean to you?
I think because I'm leaving it in a good place, I feel good about that. Last week was tough. All the lasts that lead up to that last day were tough. But then when you get to the game, it's a football game. It's something you've done hundreds of times. We won the football game, and you get into the kids' celebration, everything they do at the end, and that part of it felt good.
Was there a moment at the end of the game that you realized, oh man, it's over?
Throughout the game, just different bits and pieces of things, you know, just little things that you've done so many times. We had some backups in, and they don't get a chance to practice the victory formation, take a knee. And here I'm sitting there worrying about this when we're up by 40-some points, and I thought to myself, what are you worried about? You're never going to have to do this again. Just let them kneel down and we'll move on. So it's part of your DNA. It's just what you do.
Did you get a moment in that moment? Did you think, okay, I need to take a second and enjoy it? Did you take it in?
I was trying to before they hit me in the face with the ice cold water. And then, after that, it was, you get kind of shocked into the moment. But I've been hit in the back of the head with that bucket enough times. Because when they try to dump that on you, they always clunk you in the back of the head with it. So one of them snatched my headphones and I knew it was coming and I put my hands up so they didn't hit me in the head. But after that, it was fun. The kids got to celebrate.
You've had 15 years of memories. What stands out to you the most over the last couple years?
There's two things. My first year, we had lost our first two games. And those kids were kind of embarrassed by some things that happened around the school, people laughing at them. And they snapped back and won 7 in a row. And from there, you knew that we had the kids to make a pretty good run. And also, our first ever home playoff game against Massillon. It was the most incredible high school football experience I've ever been through from top to bottom. And so those two things stand out to me.
Did you think, I'm gonna take you back to the day you were hired. Did you think the day you were hired, we'd be sitting here almost 15 years later talking about your legacy?
No, I had a previous head coaching job at Toledo Bowser and went 0-10. And my first thought was be good at it, good enough at it for a couple years that you at least get your overall record back to 500. So I thought if I could go a couple years and win 6 games a year, at least I can kind of erase that off my record. And then it was kind of a game for me after that, how good could I get my overall record after that? So I had no idea it was gonna go 15 years and go this far.
When did you start thinking that this would be the last season?
You kind of go year by year when you've done it for a long time. There's little things. I'd like to spend some time with my parents. I have 2 daughters graduating from college. There's different things going on in life that I want to be able to spend some time at. And then this summer, with the shutdown, we got to spend a lot of time at our cottage. And I've never had much of a chance to do that. We've had this cottage since 1994, and I usually get to go about twice per summer, and then I'm back into football. And we went 5 or 6 times, and it was relaxing and fun, and I started to miss that in August, thinking, man, I'd really like to be there right now. So that's when I knew that it's time to take some time for those things.
How hard was it to tell your players that the Kregel era is done?
That was the hardest part. The week leading up to that and thinking about the hard part, thinking about telling those guys, I knew that was going to be difficult, but getting the words out was extremely hard. For a lot of reasons, I had to keep it really quiet. And, you know, a lot of people were kind of offended by that almost, but I didn't want it to be about me. I wanted it to be about the kids, and telling them was by far the hardest part.
When you told them, what were the emotions from your perspective, and then what were the emotions from the kids' perspective?
The emotions from my perspective were relief. It felt real after you said it. The kids were in shock. and the parents shared that with me, that, you know, several parents either texted or emailed that their son came home and cried, or, you know, that's not easy when you're a football coach knowing that there's that kind of emotion behind it. But you could tell the kids were extremely shocked when I told them. They didn't see that coming.
You're going to have a lot of free time. What is going to fill that free time?
Well, you've already seen I've got a lot of space to take care of here. So, you know, we've got a small chicken farm that we've been having some fun with the last couple of years. We've got a couple turkeys right now. I got a really big dog that needs a lot of attention. We're going to spend some time at our cottage. Like I said, Jen and I went there when it was still really cold out in the spring and just sat next to the fire and thought, this will be nice next spring. This is kind of what we want to do. So I've got plenty to keep me busy.
Is this truly the end of you coaching, or do you think in a couple years there's a possibility you could come back?
You never say never, but honestly, right now, I'm very content with it being the end of me coaching. It's been such a big part of our life. You never know how it's going to feel, but I also have a lot of things that I also do. I'm not one of those people that football's my entire life, and in the off season, I sit next to the laptop and just watch film nonstop. I've got a lot of other hobbies, a lot of other things I like to do to fill my time, so I think I'll be okay. I'd like to consult with other coaches and share what I know and what I've done, so I think I can keep myself busy. I think this is it.
COVID really changed high school football this season. How big of an impact was that for you? Obviously, your family dealt with it. Did that influence this decision?
It did in a way. My family tried to talk me out of it until the last day. You know, Jen mentioned, you don't want to go out with this being your last year, being the way it was. But honestly, to me, that wasn't as much about, you know, the way this year went. We had a really good record. We had a really good team. We won a league championship. As a head coach, you can deal with things like the pandemic in those things. It's the football part of it went really well, and it's a good way to end.
Now, Kregel and Perrysburg football go hand in hand. Whoever the next head coach is, what's your message to them?
I think we're leaving the program. I'm leaving the program in a really good spot. I've got some guys on my staff that want to continue to coach. We've got some really talented kids coming back. My message to the next guy is going to be that you've got kids that want to work, and they will put in as much time as you want. We don't always have the most talent, but they're going to show up and put in the hours and really work hard. So I think that's important.
You've meant a lot to the Perrysburg community over the years. Do you have a final message, a final thank you to them as you start your new chapter?
Yeah, I'd like to thank everybody for their support. I remember talking to Ray Pullman when I took the job, and both of us shared that our goal is to make football the thing to do on Friday nights in Perrysburg. And at the time it wasn't, and that's hard to believe that it just wasn't the thing to do. And within a year, it became big, and now you look at the swarm and everything that our student section does, it's become unbelievable. You know, over the years, the kids telling me, kids not involved in football, getting a hold of me and telling me, man, I can't wait until the first game. We're really excited about this. That makes you feel good. So I think that's going to continue. I think it's going to be a big part all along, and I feel good that we were the ones who kind of got that re-energized.
Next fall, are we going to see you in the stands?
Here and there, but I don't know about in the stands. Hopefully, we're past the pandemic part, and I'm one of those people that if I'm going to watch a football game, I don't want to hear all the experts while I'm watching it. And unfortunately, my wife and family had to sit with the experts this fall, and it wasn't a pleasant experience. You know, we will be at football games, and we will do it the way my family always has, kind of over in the end zone enjoying the game. So, but, you know, I'm going to be there to help the new guy. I'm going to be there to help the kids. I'm going to be there to be an ambassador for the community. It's what we've always done, and we'll continue doing that.
Was there ever a moment in the last month or so that you thought, maybe I shouldn't give it up? Or were you pretty set?
I've been pretty set since late summer. I've been pretty set that, you know, this time next year, I want to be doing some new things on my own that we haven't had a chance to do in a while.
After the game, it's you always get a family picture before interviews, and I always see you guys getting family pictures, and you get to see year after year those family pictures that they grow. What kind of personal memories are you going to take from the last 15 years?
Those things. And my coach's kids. You know, Drew Sims, I knew him since he was a little kid. It was hard to make eye contact with him the other night, and he didn't even come up to me. I could tell he was feeling the same thing, that it's better just to wave and go right now. But, you know, all those players that I knew when they were little kids and then ended up getting to coach them, and, you know, those are all things that I'll remember for a long time. And that's what made my job great, is I got to do it for a long time and got to do those things.
Anything else I'm missing out on that you want to add?
No, it's been a great run. You know, I'm completely content with making this decision, and I want to experience just being a teacher. You know, that's one thing I've never, since day one, been able to do, is really do a good job at my teaching job and not have to worry about all the things that I've got to do after school. It's almost like semi-retirement, but I still have a full-time job to do, so I'm looking forward to doing that.